wax with heat. And what I use, or what I'm going to use today, is my iron. And I'm from Massachusetts originally, so that's why.
That's iron to everyone else?
There's no R in iron.
Real iron.
And I also have our car. Our car.
I lived in Rhode Island for a while.
Oh, okay. Yeah, right there too. And then we also use a hot air gun. And this gets really hot. So you have to be careful with that. Some people use fire, but I don't trust myself with fire, so.
What, like a torch?
Yeah, torch, yeah. But these here are the basic techniques. And I did this so you could see, like, this is shuffling. And you get the iron and you shuffle it up and down, and then you get this effect. And then you have the, this one here is lifting. And you can, I don't know if you can see it, but you put the iron down and you lift it up. And what that does is it gives you, like, if you wanted to make bushes or the bottom of the ocean, you know, that kind of helps that. And then the edge, this is done with the edge. And so there's different techniques that you can use. And when you finish, you put them all together. And this is what you could come up with, something like this. I'm gonna put this on. Now I'm gonna just work with cards today because it's easier than working with anything else. I do work a lot with wood. This is my wood. There's also canvas too. This is a canvas one. I thought it was wood. I think there's a canvas one in the gallery that I did. And there's a lot of wax on that. And it's beeswax. Beeswax is used because of the melting factor of it. And it's a lot easier than it used to be because you can order all these colors online now. Some people still try to make their own colors and mix them. And I've heard some people using things like crayons or whatever. I don't think that would work. I think that, you know, you need to keep the chemicals down, and it kind of does that. So what I'm going to do is start with this guy. And when you're using it, I like it on not too high. It can be adjusted, but I want one.
Set on low?
I'm sorry?
On low?
I don't like it on low. Right in the middle, I like it. I don't know. Sometimes low, it kind of dies down when I'm doing it. I like to. And I like to use, well, let's use one color right now, just so you get the idea of it.
Oh.
You see it melting?
Yeah.
And then when you put it on the card,
I didn't think the iron touched it.
Now, you can do a lot of different things with this. Now, if
look at
ooh, how pretty.
And I like it just like that, but then you can also do you know, make a little, some trees or bushes in here. I feel like I'm under the ocean in this one. Yeah, I do. But we also have something else going on here.
How many times do you burn your finger?
I'm pretty good. I don't burn my finger too much. I get a lot of wax on them. Yeah, today I was trying to get all the wax off before I came here. And, you know, you just get something like this. This is one color that I just... Now, when you finish it, you smooth it out. and it shines. Now, you can also take some of it off if you want to rub it a little harder. And that's good when you're making, like, when you have a road and then you have water and you want to accent the water.
What are you using?
You can use tissue. And I found this today, so I said, oh yeah, that'll be good.
Kind of like
or an old sock. Socks
are
good.
Now, is that a special iron for this?
Yes, it is. Okay. Yes. They started this back in 1987. The UK brought it back, and they started making all these things.
I mean, I remember that from college from the 60s.
Mm-hmm. From the 60s. Mm-hmm. But it was never really, it's pretty big now. Not so much here, but like in the West Coast, it's very big, and in Europe.
Right. We can't do this.
And he has one.
Wow.
Now we could also do
iron. And how do you clean your iron?
Iron is cleaned with Kleenex.
Okay, so just
wipe
off.
It's still hot.
As long as it's hot, it still wipes off.
Yeah, okay. It's hot, but it's not going to burn me.
And you don't have any odor there at all.
No, no. Now, some waxes that people use do have odors. Mm-hmm.